Planet Dolan.
From how smartphones work to what would happen if the sun stopped giving off light, we answer that. Well, I don't really answer. It's going to be Hellbent, Melissa. I'm just going to read out the intro. I'm not that important. They're going to be answering 10 of your most burning questions about life. Okay, see ya. I'm going to go have a lie down. See ya.
Hey there, my name is Melissa. I'll be reading out the questions and answers.
I'm Hellbent and blah, blah, blah. Let's just start.
Aviator in Command asks, do guinea pigs, rabbits, birds, any animal that has eyes on the side of their heads really see sideways?
Oh, for sure. They have to. Birds see sideways to fend off pickpockets from stealing their bread all the time.
Caw, caw! Caw, caw!
Caw, 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 caw.
Yes, these animals can see sideways, but are really just seeing a wider image than humans do. The vision allows for them to see more easily in all directions to spot predators, since animals with such a feature are usually prey species. This wider peripheral vision means they have smaller stereoscopic vision, resulting in less depth perception compared to predator species. Valerie the Stalker asks, why do our voices sound deep when in slow motion?
I don't know what you're talking about. When I go into slow motion, I sound the same.
Oh, come on, Hellbent. We all know you're just using a voice modulator to deepen it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Knock it off!
When slowing down a recording, the sound waves are being stretched, which lowers the pitch. The way this works is that you are hearing the same frequencies at fewer sound waves per second. So, the lower the frequency, the lower the pitch. Sauce Kilo asks, how do smartphones know that you're touching the screen? And how does the touchscreen actually work?
These phones nowadays are so sensitive. Not just physically, but emotionally. Why won't this work? Come on. Come on! What the f-
Smartphones use an electrical current, and when something with electrical charge, such as the skin on our fingers, touches the screen, it creates a voltage drop. The software then locates the drop and processes it accordingly. Smartphones use this capacitive system, which does not rely on pressure, allowing for multiple parts of the screen to be touched at the same time. However, it means that you cannot wear gloves while using your phone.
Here you go, Melissa. This phone isn't working right.
What? My phone! Give that back! Ah, you got it all dirty! Let me clean it. Camwood7 asks, what was the first social networking site?
The first social networking site was called a park. This is where people went outside to meet people and talk face to face. This was before everyone became recluses and all started to hide behind their monitors at home.
6degrees is considered the first proper social networking site, since it was the first to allow users to create profiles, organize groups, and become friends with other users. It was launched in 1997 and shut down in 2001. It allowed users to see their connection to other users. Prior to 6degrees, there were dating sites and classmates.com, which connected users with old classmates.
Here, Melissa, I got some bread for you. Catch!
Ow! Ugh. KaylaCat556 asks, when a part of your body falls asleep, why does it feel like needles?
Oh no, you have that? Needle leg? Oh my god, that's awful! Your limbs are gonna start falling off, and you're gonna need a wheelchair to get around like Gooby, a full-on mermaid bod. That's horrible! Say, can I have your shoes? I mean, you're not gonna be needing them.
This sensation is your nerves, sending signals again after the blood flow returns to the cutoff area. When there is pressure on a certain part of the body, it falls asleep, meaning that the blood has been cut off to the nerves and they are unable to send signals to the brain. This is why you can't feel anything until blood flow returns to normal. Master of Fire Entertainment asks, if we stacked up everyone in the world, can we reach the sun or the moon?
We could reach the sun, but not the moon. The sun is really small, see? Here, Melissa, let's start the stack with you. Fly! Fly!
I can't! You're too heavy!
You can't fly because you're too fat! Try harder!
If everyone were stacked up, we would reach the moon, but not the sun. In fact, it would take approximately 286 million people to reach the moon. the entire population stacked on top of each other would reach 9.8 million kilometers, which is only 1/15 of the weight of the sun. Oh, my back. It hurts.
You just have a broken spine, also known as spinitis. Just walk it off. Oh wait, I forgot you can't because you're so fat!
Epic Gaming 001 asks, are there more males overall than females?
Males are the superior master gender. Yeah, I am a manimist. I strongly believe the fact that men can do all and everything better than women, especially manly man stuff. Like chopping down trees or driving a motorcycle. Ah, my spinitis is acting up! Ah, curse you, spinitis!
Oh my god! Here, hold on. I'll call an ambulance. Hello? Hello? Amongst the total population of Earth, there are more males to females at a ratio of 1.01 to 1. At birth, males outnumber women at a rate of 1.01 to 1. However, after the age of 55, women outnumber men at a rate that increases with age. In the USA, Europe, and Australia, however, there are slightly more females to males. King of the Roblox asks, is everyone on Earth related and or a giant family?
Well, some countries do have big families that spread all along an entire area. Take Australia, for example. Here we can see Dolan and his family and... I gotta go.
Yes, it has been proven that everyone on Earth is related. Through genetic research, it has been shown that we all have common ancestors. The generation with which we share a common ancestor is estimated to have lived 3,400 years ago. This was done through the length of shared DNA segments. The longer the segment, the more closely related the people. Mim Xanadunst asks, how long would life last if our sun suddenly stopped emitting light?
Horrifically boring nerds like Melissa will be just fine staying inside, reading books and playing educational video games all day in their rooms. Unfortunately for cool guys like me, we'll probably all be wiped out. I'm sure it'll all be in one big hell of a party, though. I'd invite you, Melissa, but I don't think you'd really fit in.
It is most likely that people would not survive longer than a few months. The average temperature on Earth would quickly plummet, reaching minus 18 degrees Celsius after only a week. It would quickly reach temperatures too cold for humans to survive in. Apart from the cold, the plants would also die all within 1 week due to absence of sunlight. The food supply would then run out in a short period of time. Tyreek Smith asks, why can't we remember everything from the day we were born?
Melissa doesn't remember anything about her childhood because of how stupid she is, but I have a pretty good idea about how it went. Her parents were dumb and no one liked them or their new baby. Not even her parents liked Melissa. Her family ditched her because they hated her so-
Shut up, you stupid jerk! I'm so sick of you and your rude attitude!
Wait! Look!
I'm not falling for that.
No, really, Melissa, look!
What?
Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a cool one!